Welcome to Yellow Brick Road. I am Jordan, and today I'm going to talk about these two assholes, the most influential, or not influential, the most admired men in America. Yeah. But first, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. Click the link, read the story, check out the other donations, make a donation yourself. None of the money goes to us, it goes to charity. One of our subscribers and his wife helps him pay medical bills. So, if you're in a giving mood this holiday season and you want to donate to a charity, you can do so at Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. All right. So we have a tweet here from ABC News Politics. It reads, President Donald Trump and former President Barack Obama tied for the top spot as America's most admired man in 2019. According to Gallup's annual poll, marking the first time for Trump has earned the distinction, and the 12th time for Obama. That's right. Two literal, like, baby killers are the most admired men in the country. can you believe that shit? Like, how many dead bodies have to pile up till the stench reaches America and they fucking wake up and look at these two assholes and call them out for what they are. Or excuse me, call them out for how they behave. I'm still trying to diagnose what they are. It's like it's human-like, but, you know, if you don't have a soul there, it's like you're more of a humanoid than a human being. And you could just run down the list of things they'd even out with, you know, from funding rebels in Syria to, you know, bombing Syria to sanctions in South America to sanctions in the Middle East, just over and over again. Prosecution of Julian Assange, right? Obama was on his way to doing it and stopped. And then Trump said, I'll go through with it. Some might even say that Obama stopped knowing that the next person would continue it. And he's like, let me just save my presidency. Let me pardon Chelsea Manning because I know the next person's just going to keep this cycle going. Let me cancel the pipeline knowing the next guy is going to continue it. But, you know, blood won't be on my hands. This is terrible. Because this poll, this thing, is about personalities. It's not about how these people actually behave, right? And the Noam Chomsky thing comes to mind of the Nuremberg trials. Like, yeah, these two would be fucking prosecuted and convicted easily. And if you ask me, they're not even cool personalities. Like, Trump looks like a slobby dude who, like, you don't seem tough at all. Like, all the things people give you credit for, you don't, like, I'd read through that, no, he's not a tough guy. He's not, you know, he's just a real blue-collar type of guy. He ain't that. Not at all. Obama, same shit. He's not the cool guy who listens to the trendy stuff on the side and lets everyone know about it. He's kind of pop culture. You can even look at, a music list he put out. It's like, dude, a PR rep could have easily put that together. Easily. It's like, you're not cool, man. Certain shit you can't, certain shit he won't be able to, approach in reality. If one of these mainstream rappers made a fucking anti-war song, going over his foreign policy, he wouldn't be able to say, yeah, I like that. Unless it came down to it for a PR move, you know. See, Obama's sorry for everything he did. He liked this tweet from rapper Little Blue Blah, whatever the fuck their names are. And also, I'll dunk on him too. He's not an athlete either. They let him score. That dude would get fucking, yeah, nuts in face. I'm not gonna let him score like these NBA dudes do. Like, nah, son, I'm pinning your shit on the glass. So it's like, what? For me, it's like I'd see nothing to admire here. Nothing. Right? No sort of moral crusade. I like, oh, I like something. I like that. No fire. No. Nothing crazy here. Just boring ass political figures with, you know, they have fanboys holding up a mask for them. But, yeah. Since I can't reach them, I guess I'll shit on the fanboys until they get out of the fucking way. And you start looking at them for what they are. Go look at the scars and the moldy faces and the fucking maggots crawling out of the eyes. Fucking fanboys. You're the reason these two are admired like that. When there's probably someone out there doing real shit. And they get no one looks at them. Alright, that's it for me. Please subscribe if you like, comment, agree, disagree. Would you vote for one of these two assholes? For either one? I vote for neither. It's like, baby killers, you're automatically off the list of admirable. There's nothing to admire about you. Zippo. And everything else that someone might like is borrowed from somewhere else. Right? It's done in test rooms. Right? You know when advertisement companies test products out? Like, oh, how do people like this thing? And they do little, you know, test groups. That's what created these two assholes. They ain't got shit for them. Or they ain't got shit going for themselves. They need you fanboys to keep them afloat. Without the fanboys, like, people will see them for what the fuck they are. Or how the fuck they behave, I should say. So yeah, tell me in the comment section. Don't forget to donate Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. And with all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you wanna get him.